exam day guidelines for JEE mains and how to score 150 plus marks in JEE mains, and what are the last minute tips, tricks, and cheat codes for JEE mains. Okay, watch this video till the end so that you will get complete information from this video. Half knowledge is very dangerous. That's why make sure you watch this video till the end. Okay, so now let's begin this video without any delay. Let's see what are JEE mains exam day guidelines. Okay, so first important guideline is you need to fill self declaration form. Okay, self declaration form. Okay, so coming to the self declaration form, the form will be around 4 pages. You need to download the self declaration form and completely fill that form. Okay, so coming to the self declaration form, the form will be asking, did you come across any person affected with the virus, or are you having any of the symptoms of the virus? Okay, so all these questions will be asked. You need to fill the entire form, and there you will be asked to stick your passport size photo, and it will also need your parent signature and your signature also. And coming to the important instruction regarding the self declaration form, you need to fill the whole 4 pages form, and you need to take it to examination center, examination hall. Okay, make sure you don't forget to take your parent's signature. Okay, so this is the first point. And second important exam day guideline is you need to take your own stationery. Okay, you need to take your own stationery. Because examination hall, they will only provide you the blank sheets. Only 4 to 5 blank sheets they'll be providing. Initially, they'll give you 2 to 3 blank sheets for rough work, and if you require any more, they'll provide you those also. But rest all stationery, such as your ball pen, all these kind of things, you only need to carry with you. Okay, and blank papers will be surely provided in the exam hall. Okay, so next important guideline is you need to reach the exam hall. You need to reach the exam center before 1 hour. At least before 1 hour. Okay, so as you already know the current situation, there will be many protocols which you need to undergo. The students will be sent to the exam hall slot wise and batch wise, and there will be temperature check. They'll be also checking whether you have any symptoms, and all these things they'll be checking, and they'll also scan the barcode which is on your admit card, and they'll also check whether you have all your identity proofs and admit card, and they'll also check whether you have correctly filled out the declaration form or not. So all these things will take time. So it's always better if you reach your exam center at least before 1 hour. Okay, so next important guideline is take at least 4 passport size photos with you. Okay, so passport size photos will be really important for you. So it is always better if you carry at least 4 additional passport size photos with you. Okay, next important instruction is carry your own sanitizer. Okay, small sanitizer is always important to carry. They'll allow up to 60 ml of sanitizer, so it's always better to carry your own sanitizer, own water bottle. Okay, transparent water bottle. Okay, due to the current situation in exam hall or in exam center, they are not going to provide water for you. NTA has instructed asking students who are attempting the exam to carry their own transparent water bottle. Okay. Important instruction is maintain social distancing. Okay. You might be already seen the videos where few of the exams, entrance exams and competitive exams which were conducted recently, in that particular exams there is no social distance followed, there was no precautions taken. So at the end of the day, life is very important. So it's suggested sincerely to maintain social distance, okay, at least maintain 2 feet distance. Next important instruction is don't forget to carry your admit card and ID card. Admit card and ID card. ID proof. There will be QR code on the admit card. Exam center, they will be scanning that admit card QR code. So, it's most important to carry admit card and ID proof. So, now let's see how to score 150 plus marks in JEE mains. Okay. So first important thing is you need to concentrate on high weightage topics. Okay. Concentrate on high weightage topics. Okay, so what does it mean? So what is meant by concentrating on high weightage topics? For example, let's take maths as an example. In maths, let's think there are 4 different chapters. Okay, this is just an example. Okay, so from there are, let's think there are 4 different topics. And coming to the first topic, in previous year's papers, the weightage is 2 questions will be asked in this first top from the first topic, 1 question will be asked from the second topic, 4 questions will be asked from the third topic, and 6 questions will be asked from the fourth topic. If this is the case, first you need to concentrate on fourth topic and third topic. Okay, then if you still have time, then go for first topic. Like this, based on the questions asked from the topic and based on the weightage, you need to prioritize which topics to concentrate. Okay. Attempt to the questions in which you are confident. Attempt to the questions in which you are confident. Okay, for example, in after seeing the paper, you understood that few questions are very easy. You're feeling that few questions are very easy and you're very confident that you're going to solve them very quickly. So first go for those questions and first attempt those questions. Okay, and also start solving easy questions. If you have for example, if you have 10 questions in the paper and out of which 4 are difficult, 2 are moderate, 4 are easy, first go for these 4 easy questions and solve them. Okay, if you start solving difficult questions, most of the time will be occupied just for these difficult questions. Instead of that, if you start solving easy questions first and then moderate questions, within first few minutes you can solve all the moderate and easy questions, and then at last when you have plenty much time, then you can go for solving difficult question. Okay, so this is very intelligent strategy which each and every student who is giving JEE mains must remember and follow. Okay, don't spend much time on single question. Okay, if you start spending so much time on a single question, at the final stage you will be running out of the time. You will not have time even to solve the questions which are very easy and which you are very confident upon. Okay, so don't waste much time on single question. Okay, if you are not getting answer for single question, if you are unable to solve that question within less than 1 minute or 1.5 minute, then go for next question. Okay, so next important tip is think and answer. Think and answer. See, sometimes what happened is, if there are four options for a question, two options will be really near, okay? There will be like very similar. Two of the options will be very similar and the students will be confused. Like, out of two options, what is the correct answer? That's why you need to first of all read the question twice. Read the question carefully. That's why you need to read the question carefully and then start solving the question. Okay. So next important thing is time management. Time management is really important. Allocate time for each and every question. Okay. First, before entering into the exam hall only, fix your mind that you have very limited time to solve the paper. That's why allocate the time before only. Okay. If you think you need to allocate only 1 minute for a single question, after 1 minute, you need to proceed with second question. Okay. You need not get stuck on single question. Don't random guess. Only go for intelligent guess. So what does this mean? First, let's see what is meant by random guess. Okay. For example, let's think there are four questions. Okay. For first question, answer is A. Second question, answer is A. Third question, answer you got as A. And you are unable to solve the fourth question. And you don't know the answer for fourth question. Okay. You should not blindly guess that. Okay. So first three questions has answer as option A. So fourth question also may be having answer A as option. Okay. So like this is called random guess. This is absolutely wrong procedure. You should not follow random guess. Okay. Just go for intelligent or logical guess. Okay. What is meant by intelligent or logical guess means? See, for example, let's think you have a question and you have four different options. And after solving this problem or after seeing this question, you understood that the correct answer may be one of either answer A or answer D. Okay. You are confident that B and C are wrong options. Okay. So in this particular situation, you can guess. Okay. You can guess the relevant option. You can see, as you're left only with two options in this particular case, you already eliminated two options. You are just left with two options. And if you wanted to take risk, you can go for these kind of guesses. This is called intelligent or logical guess. Okay. So next important point is prioritize. Priority is very important even while your preparation or even while solving your exam paper. It's really important to prioritize. First understand from which subject to solve, from which subject to answer, and from which question to answer. Subject in the sense, out of the available subjects, select one subject, and out of questions, out of three different levels of questions, that is, you'll be having easy questions, moderate questions, and difficult level questions, right? First, you need to go for easy level questions and start solving them, okay? Next important thing is concentrate on each and every question. While reading the question, while solving the problem, your 100% concentration should be in the question only. You should not think about anything else. Okay. See, spend first few minutes in reading the question paper. Okay. So that you'll understand how many questions are difficult, how many questions are easy, how much time approximately you're going to take to solve the paper. Okay. You'll get a rough figure of the question paper. So spend first few minutes in reading the question paper. Okay. So next is read the question correctly. Okay. This tip is really important. A few questions will be really confusing. You may ask in two different forms. Okay. Choose the option which is Correct. Choose the option which is incorrect. Okay. So few other questions also will be there, such as what is the this kind of question and what is not the. They'll ask you to choose the option which is what is the, and they may also ask the question in the form of what is not the so and so. Okay. So if you miss this not in the question, if you miss out reading not in the question, the answer is going to be wrong. Okay, so that's why read the question correctly. And another important thing is, don't panic after checking the paper. Okay, if you don't know answers for the few questions, it's absolutely fine. And remember other important point, if you are feeling the paper tough, then all the students are also going to be feeling the same. They will also feel the paper tough. Okay, so you're not the only person who are feeling the tough. There are thousands of the students who are along with you, so the paper for them also will be equally tough. Okay, and don't panic, just be confident. See what is JEE Mains last minute preparation tips and cheat codes. Okay, so first let's see cheat codes. Coming to the cheat codes, first is elimination method. Okay, first is elimination method. What is elimination method? Let's see. What is elimination method? Let's see. Let's see now. Okay, so let's think, there is one question and there are four options, and the options are 45, 46, 52, 58. Okay, these are the options. After solving this particular question, you got the answer as 47. Okay, so now what we need to do is, whatever answer you got, find the nearest value in the given options. Okay, so what is the nearest value for 47? Not 52, not 58, not 55. 46 is the nearest value for your answer. So put B as answer. This is first method, which is called elimination method. Okay, so second is logical guess. What is logical guess? Let's think, there is a question and there are four different options, and after solving this question, you understood that option A is wrong, option D is wrong. Correct answer is going to be either in option B or option C. At this particular time, you can use the intelligent guess. Think logically. Remember, try to remember the concepts which you have already read, and use your common sense, and you can put either B or C as correct answer. Okay, so out of these two options, whatever correct answer you feel as, go for it and put that. Okay, this is called logical guess. So now let's see cheat code for matrices. The question is, if x square plus x plus 1, x minus 2, 2x square plus 3x minus 1, 3x, 3x minus 3, x square plus 2x plus 3, 2x minus 1, 2x minus 1 is equal to ax minus 12, then what is the value of a is the question. Now what we need to do is just substitute x is equal to 1. Okay, same. We are substituting 1 in the place of x, and substitute the same. 1 square plus 1 is 1. X plus 1, that is in place of x we kept 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. X minus 2, that is 1 minus 2. Minus 1. If you substitute 1 in the place of x, you will get 4. Here if you 3 into 1 is 3. 3x minus 3 is 0. Here you will be getting 6, 1, 1. Okay, is equal to a into 1 minus 12. Just expand the values which you got. Okay, in the LHS side, whatever values we got, we just need to expand them. Okay, after expanding this, we will be getting 2 into 3 is 2 into 4 minus 1, 4 minus 18. Okay, just nothing we are doing. We are just expanding this matrix. Okay, so after solving this equation, we'll be getting answer as 12. Okay, so in the left hand side, we got answer as 12. In the left hand side, after solving all these things, we got 12. And in right hand side, we are writing this as it is, which is a into x minus 12. We know the value of x is 1. We are substituting the value of x is as 1. And so 12 is equal to a minus 12. Minus 12 into left hand side, a is equal to 12 plus 12, which is 24. Okay, so the correct answer is 24. See, within less than a minute. See, now I'm explaining you. That's why it took 1.5-2 minutes. Normally, when you solve this, it's going to take less than 30 seconds. Okay, so yeah, this is other important cheat code for mathematics. Okay, especially for matrices. Now let's see what are other last minute tips. Analyze your mock test. In the previous video, I already told mock test is very important. Taking mock test is really important, because after taking mock test, you'll understand where you are getting stuck, in which particular subject or in which particular topic you need to practice more. You need to practice more. So all these things you will understand only while you're only after giving mock test. Okay, so what all mock tests you have taken, just analyze them. Okay, what are the mistakes you made in the mock test? Just analyze them so that you will not repeat them in your main exam. Okay, and also analyze where you're getting stuck and where you're wasting your time. Okay, so work on those topics mostly. So next important thing is revise formula. Formula are very important. It's very important to start revising your formula, because once you remember the formula, you can easily solve the question. And next important tip is, don't study for long hours. Better not to study continuously for long hours. See, when you take a short break in between your study hours, then only your brain can concentrate well on whatever you are studying. So don't sit continuously for long hours. Start taking at least 10 to 20 minutes break for every 2 hours. Okay, next important tip is, arrange all your essential things. Arrange essential things. What are essential things? Essential things in the sense, admit card, ID card, declaration form, pen, water bottle, passport size photos. So all these things are essentials. Okay, so make sure the day before your exam only, you need to pack all these things and keep aside, okay? So that next day, you will not waste time in searching your ID proof, in searching your admit card. All these things will not happen, okay? Stop overthinking, okay? Most of the students will really work so much hard for their exam. They'll sacrifice their sleep, they'll sacrifice their food also, but still, just before the day of exam, they'll start panicking. What if the questions which I read don't come? What if I forget whatever I read? What if I some such thought of questions? So stop overthinking, concentrate on the present moment. Don't think too much, just study, and you're going to rock in the exam. Okay, so next important tip is, don't discuss with your friends. See, few students, what will they do is, they'll call their friends, They'll ask how much they studied. If the friend told he have already studied everything and he have even completed the revision, then we will start panicking, and whatever we study also we will tend to forget them. So better don't discuss anything, don't talk with any of your friends, just relax, talk with your parents, calm down yourself, talk only with positive people. Don't let negative thoughts affect you, okay? So next important tip is revise what you have already studied, okay? So these many days, what have you studied, just revise those things. Don't go for new things in the last moment. When you start studying new topics or new concepts in the last day, you will not remember them, and you will also forget the things what you have already studied, okay? So better not to start studying any new topics just before your exam or just the day before your exam, okay? So just revise the things which you have already studied. And other important tip I would like to give is the students who are traveling alone to your exam center, make sure you carry only few things, because the bags or the accessories or anything which you carry to your exam or exam center will be of your responsibility, because the exam center people and the authorities are not going to take responsibility for the lost things. If you lose anything in the exam center or in the exam hall, they are not going to take responsibility for that. So better travel less, take only few things which are very important, and don't take so many things because you can't carry all of them to exam hall, okay? So other important thing is if your parents or if your siblings are coming along with you for your exam, better ask them to leave once you enter into the exam hall, because in this pandemic it's really not suggested to stay in the crowded areas for so long. So it's better ask them to go, and just before 10-15 minutes of your exam, they can come back to exam center. They can till then sit in a non-crowded area waiting for you. And other last important tip is sleep early. Sleep is really important. Whatever you study, it will go to long-term memory only via rest, okay? Don't prefer having oily breakfast. Eat something light, eat something healthy, so that any other kind of disturbances won't be while you exam, okay? So yeah, that's it for today, guys. You have worked so much hard for your exam. Just stay positive, just be confident, okay? I hope this video is really helpful for you guys. This video is really, really requested from many of the students who are attempting JEE. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you will never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching. All the best. Maintain social distancing. Don't forget your sanitizer and mask, and also admit card as well. So yeah, all the very best to your exam. Thanks for watching.